I'm Paul Wilkinson, and today I'm going to show you a meditation using singing bowls. You can probably hear it just started torrential rain in my garden. So we're filming from Kathmandu. I'm shouting a little bit because of the sound of the rain, so I don't know how much it will show up on the microphone, but I want to show you the relationship between using some qigong exercises and the Tibetan singing bowls. So just playing very steadily like this, getting the sound moving from the bowl, breathing deeply down into the belly, and then on the in-breath, then I think we might have to abandon it.
Yeah.
I'm going to show something else in the rain, okay?
Okay.
We might even be able to use this, who knows?
Yeah.
It's raining pretty heavy with the... Okay. What I'm doing is, as I'm playing it, on the in-breath I'm bringing the bowl up, and on the out-breath I'm bringing the bowl down, and you can use the singing bowl to help you feel the vibration through into the body. So with a large bowl it's quite easy to feel the vibration through the bowl and into the body, and you can use that as a way of training the breath and training the energy to rise up the spine into the crown of the head, and then through the palate down towards the microcosmic orbit. So I'll show you the related qigong. So rise with the qigong, do your wider shot. Niraj, pull back to a wide shot with the feet. long version, or the simplest version. There's three different types of rounds that you can do with this. So the simplest is this. So you probably notice I'm standing shoulder width apart. I'm tucking, opening up my hips, pushing my pelvis forward, tucking in the tail of the spine, and I'm pulling up from the cranium with my breath. So this is a very, very good way of energizing yourself when you're meditating. We're rising up slightly on the in-breath, sinking down, sinking all the tension from the shoulders, sinking everything down into the ground on the out-breath. One of the really important things with meditation with the singing bowls, or with meditation in general, is to be very, very present. And so in this case, where suddenly the heavens have opened up and it's really raining, and you can see I'm now drenched, what I'm doing is I'm focusing on the quality of the rain also washing through me. So I'm bringing my awareness into my skin. Actually, when you focus into the belly center, you can keep yourself warm when it's very cold. So this isn't particularly cold because it's monsoon in Kathmandu, but if you're doing this in, say, English weather where it might be freezing, you can actually keep your body very warm by pumping the breath into the belly and pulling up from the perineum and pressing the breath down like a furnace. So if you want to give yourself a lot of extra energy, also if you want to protect yourself, if you feel that there's some sort of encroaching energy or negativity, or maybe negative magic as well, the more internal power you have, the more energy you give out, and that actually makes it very hard for the negative to stick to you. So the more you're a sort of generative force, the more your light spreads out, and the less easy it is for the negative or the dark forces to find some way into you. So I'll just show with the singing bowl again. I've abandoned the little bowl because it's now, when it's wet, it becomes really hard to play the small bowl. But in the big bowl has so much resonance that I should still be able to play. to focus on individual energy centers on the belly or on the heart or the diaphragm as a center of focus for building the energy. I'll show you the round again. Allowing everything to come out from the shoulders and to go down, allowing it to sink with the raindrop. Pressing the breath down. Breathing into the belly, feeling the heartbeat, allowing your awareness to go into the pauses between the heartbeats. So when you're playing the singing bowl, there's also a beat that you feel in the singing bowl. To that interior world. So the beat of the heartbeat and the pause between the beats become a focus of attention, a focus of awareness. Something else that you can do with rain is also allow the consciousness of the rain touching you to be washing everything, to be washing everything clear. So it's like a sort of cleansing. So again, from a sort of shamanic perspective, you can use the elements like this. So you notice I didn't stop when it began raining, and most people would just go inside. But actually the rain is wonderful, and it's probably a funny video, but the quality of the rain can become an addition, can become an amazing tool for deeper focus, and an amazing way to bring yourself deeper inside. So I hope that was useful, and please subscribe, do let me know any sort of feedback or videos you want to see, and I'll see you at the next one.